We blast you and you assholes! Hold up!
On the front!
For brain.
Huh?
Thank you.
hot today.
Slaughterhouse, satisfy your instincts.
Sell your kidney or something?
Maybe.
For the record, it's gorgeous, but that many eddies? Was it really worth it?
I've got no regrets. There's no shame in wanting perfection.
artificial meat.
I beg your pardon?
He made his fortune from artificial meat.
And they let him in?
Yep.
I don't believe it. This used to be an elite club, and now... Now they'll take anyone who makes an Eddie more than a garbage collector.
Girl, your new nose is fabulous. I think it's your best yet. Hardly recognized you. You should have seen me on set last week. Wardrobe swapped out everything, even my voice. They made me into this rippling stud, and oh, I'd have flown myself if I could.
You landed another male role?
You know, I really shouldn't be telling you this. But I beat out Tom Bradley for the role.
Oh, our girl is on fire.
Well, seems I'm almost all boy these days.
Ooh. Separating the lies from the truth, or at least giving it a damn good try anyway. So let's look at the first theory, eh? This one's promoted by the NUSA Militech and Federalists. They tell us that Arasaka self-destructed the tower to prevent Militech from seizing the building and liberating Night City. Hey, if you listen to the story from someone like President Kress, with the Pentagon, Arasaka blew themselves up as an act of spite. Knowing they were losing the battle for Night City, they detonated a nuclear device in their own HQ to prevent it from falling into the hands of the enemy, and ensuring that the resulting destruction would keep the Americans busy picking through the debris. Yeah, right. The story is full of holes. They weren't losing the battle for the city, and they had no reason to blow themselves up. On the contrary, at that point in the war, the high brass in the U.S. government were getting pretty damn tired with this war. And they were getting ready to end it by any means necessary, and that put Militech in a pretty tight spot. What's true here is that Arasaka did have a nuclear self-destruct device in the building. But I promise you, that wasn't the source of the explosion that night. The weird thing is, no one ever found that Arasaka nuke, intact or otherwise, in the rubble. Which means that thing is still out there somewhere.
Hey, baby. Give me a kiss.
See? Hello? You have any idea?